Hello. So we're going to talk about, is being acid unhealthy? I hear this so much where everyone needs to alkalize or you're going to die, right? That we need to alkalize the body because acid is unhealthy. First of all, you need to know that your body has different acid and alkaline levels. It's not just one. For example, your saliva ranges between 6.5 and 7.5. So just realize 7 is neutral. Anything higher is alkaline. Anything lower is acid. Okay, so we got 6.5, that's slightly acid. 7.5, it's slightly alkaline. So your saliva should range. And by the way, when you go from a 7 to an 8, that's by a factor of 10 times more alkaline. Or 7 to 6 is 10 times more acid. So it's magnified. So okay, saliva is slightly alkaline, slightly acidic. Small intestine, 7 to 8.5. So your small intestine is usually slightly alkaline. But the large intestine is between 4 and 6. That's acid. Interesting. So check out the blood. It's a very, very narrow range between 7.35, slightly alkaline, and 7.45, which is a little more alkaline. It's such a narrow range. That's interesting to me that it's that tight of a controlled pH. So I guess when people talk about being acid or alkaline or alkalosis or acidosis, they're really talking about the pH in the blood. So if your pH is between like 7.46 or 7 or 8, you're going to basically have alkalosis. If it's 7.34 or 7.33, you're going to have acidosis, even though it's off just slightly. Okay? But that's a whole different seminar. The point I want to make is that your body has different pHs in different fluids. Your stomach should be between 1 and 3. Do you realize how acid that is? That's like seriously like acid. It's like battery acid. Your urine should be between 4.5 and 6.0, acid. So we got the large intestine, the stomach, and the urine should be acid. A lot of the other fluids should be alkaline. So this whole thing that everyone should be alkaline is kind of like, well, what tissue are you talking about? The purpose of having the right pH is that it allows the body to then release or activate enzymes. Let me give you an example. If your stomach is not acid enough, it will not release the enzyme peptidase, the most powerful proteolytic or protein enzyme. So you're not going to digest protein. So what's going to happen with that? You're going to get undigested protein, allergies. If the stomach is not acid enough, you're not going to be able to kill off viruses and bacteria and microbes. If the stomach is not acid, you're not going to absorb minerals. You'll become anemic. So there's a lot of issues with just not activating enzymes. Also, you need these differences in pHs to move fluids through the body, to have things move. If your body was just one pH, things would just be stagnant. They wouldn't move that well. So we need the diversity. So the next time someone says, oh yeah, you're too acid, you need to alkalize, you're like, ask them, what tissue are you talking about? What fluid are you talking about? The blood, and then it's really hard to test the blood pH. So, because as soon as you take it out of the body, it oxidizes with air and it changes the pH. So rarely does anyone ever test it. So you gotta go by symptoms, basically. But the pH that does change, probably the only pH that does change dramatically out of all these fluids, is the stomach pH. As you age, from 20 to 30 to 40 to 50 to 60, 70 years old, look at how far down your stomach pH goes down. You lose the acid in your pH and your stomach becomes more alkaline. So the danger of that is that you're going to lose the digestion. So red meat's going to be hard to assimilate. So you're going to get kind of like gas and bloating if you have too much. You're going to have gas is a perfect indication of low stomach acids, bloating as well. Also, you need the strong pH to release the enzymes from the pancreas and the gallbladder to release its bile so you just don't get those digestive secretions and then you end up with more bloating. If you combine too many different foods at once, especially with sugar, you're going to get some, and you don't have enough acid in your stomach, you're going to get some serious bloating in your stomach. So we need a really strong pH. So the older you get, the worse the pH is in the stomach. And then because the valve doesn't close, you get GERD and things like that. But what do people take when they have indigestion, acid reflux, or heartburn? They take antacids. So the older you get and the more you're taking antacids, what are you doing? You're taking that last bit of acid that you had and you're making it go bye-bye. So the older you are, the more acidic you need to start. You need to start putting things back in there. Like, that's why I recommend apple cider vinegar. So it's so important. If you just took everyone over the age of 50 and put them on apple cider vinegar, you would see some amazing changes in digestion. But over time, your blood pH doesn't go, you don't lose acid in your blood pH. You don't lose it in the saliva or small intestine. It's mainly in the stomach. So that's the area that I would recommend focusing on. So being too acid and unhealthy? No, not if you're talking about the stomach. If you don't like taking apple cider vinegar because it irritates your teeth, whatever, you can take it as a pill form. Apple cider vinegar plus. I'm changing the name to digestion, digest support. But this is good to take right before a meal to help improve the completeness of your digestion, specifically with proteins, and to help support a healthy pH in your stomach. All right, thanks for watching. Hi guys. Hey, listen, I created a pretty amazing evaluation quiz down below that actually analyzes your symptoms to find the cause, the root cause of all of your symptoms, the most likely cause. So take the quiz now and we'll send you a report.